I have a good friend who about 15 years ago had a traumatic brain injury in an auto accident. Mm-hmm. And after 7 or 8 years wandering around in the wilderness trying to get diagnosed and treated at all, finally got some traction. Now, she still is disabled to the extent that she can't hold a standard 9-to-5 job. But about a year ago, I took up the low-carb, ketogenic sort of program in my own life, and she liked what it did for me physically and adopted it about 2 months ago herself. And what she tells me is that her emotional life is a lot more stable than mm-hmm. it used to be. And my knee-jerk reaction was, yeah, you got off the sugar roller coaster.
Right.
But some of the things I've heard at the conference made me wonder if there was some basis for leveling out your emotions in a more ketogenic energy source.
You know, and this is where it's cool, where it works synergistically, and we may not fully know what the mechanisms are, but clearly everybody understands that if we're not on that carb roller coaster, our emotional state is better. How many people have heard that exercise increases brain, can increase growth of new brain connections, new brain tissue? So there's a substance called BDNF, brain-derived neurotrophic factor. Do you know what the signaling molecule is that releases and activates and makes efficacious brain-derived neurotrophic factor? Beta-hydroxybutyrate. It's ketone bodies. If you can't produce ketone bodies, you don't grow new brain.